everybody. This is Perry from A Plus Slingshots. Today I wanted to do a short video to show you how to install the new longer, what we call adjust-a-bands, that goes on the lever bow, it goes on the Timberwolf series, and the Jackalope as well. If you're ordering 20 or 30 pound bands, you're going to get one band, and it'll do approximately 20 pounds to 30 pounds, or maybe just a little bit more, but about 30 pounds. So let me show you how that is. So that's a longer band, and this is what we do. We use two band stops, and I'll show you how to use those. They'll be enclosed in the package. You can get these for me. You just have to ask me. We charge a couple dollars for them, but you can make them easily enough. This is just a strong string. Ours is a Spectre line, I believe, but you can use almost anything. And then I tie it like that on a key ring, but you can, you know, just do an overhand loop. I use beeswax, and I keep it coated for several reasons. It allows it to slip well, but also keeps it kind of strong and stiff, and you'll see why that's kind of important in just a minute. So let me show you how you do this. You, first of all, take your lever bow or whatever sling bow that you're going to install these on, and you run it through the front toward the back. Does that make sense? So that's just there. Then here's something incredibly important on all of our sling bows, and I don't know if I've ever said this, but we have enough people ordering replacement bands now that it's important to do so. If you notice the D-loop, if you put the bands on the wrong way, it will actually try to lift up the arrow off the arrow rest. So you need to make sure that when you're seeing it, that the D-loop is coming from underneath the archery yoke. And so that means you'll see two little burnt beads of the material, the melted, I guess is what I'm saying, melted bits of the material, the knots, on the top. So when that's on your sling bow, that's going to be on the top, that you'll see it on the top. And the D-loop looks like it's coming from underneath. If you put it on like this and you see the wrap-overs, that's not the right way. Hopefully that's wrong. That's correct. Okay. So what you do is you make sure that it's going to go the right direction, and then you go about halfway or so, and you, hopefully you can see this right, you bend the band toward the side. Hopefully that makes sense. Bend the band toward the side. So it's made just a little loop like that. Then you take the string loop that you've gone through the hole and pass it through that, and then pass it back through the hole. Hopefully that's making sense and you can see that. This to the side, and then you just pull it through. Take your string out, lay it aside. So you can, that's what it looks like from the top. Okay, then you take your string stop, which is another piece of the tube, and you put it in the hole. And then, if you're going to do 30 pound, it's going to be about 4 inches, so you can kind of get it that way. Keep that in place, and then just pull the other side. What I do when I make sure that it's the right poundage is I come to the head and get 4 inches. It's not quite. So what you do is work this back and forth, just pull it a little bit, and you're going to pull more. So now it should be longer. You can check it if you want to. These are approximates, but that's about 4 inches. And then what I do is I tighten it down. Does that make sense? So it's in there and tightened down. And then you're going to repeat the procedure on this side. If you decide you wanted it 30 pounds and you don't want it adjustable, you're not going to say, you know, have a child or someone else that wants to shoot a lower weight. This doesn't hurt anything, but if you'd like to take it off and you've got it set, just make sure you always cut it no more than about an inch to an inch and a half from this. That way you have a bit of an adjustment, and if there's any slippage, which there's usually not, once it's really in there secure, that will give you enough that you can still adjust it and tighten it back up. But it's usually very secure. So, but I always leave about an inch at the very least. And it doesn't hurt just to leave it that way. So when you're finished, what you get is like that. And of course, it works just like normal with the release. So again, some might find that, you know, floppy, kind of irritating. If you do, and you know that the poundage that you want, just cut it off. Otherwise, leave it alone. It doesn't hurt anything, and it gives you an adjustable band that somebody that might be weaker can utilize that. So again, simple tools, a string tool, some beeswax or bowstring wax. If you have that, that's fine. This is just a cake of beeswax. Measuring tape to check the distance. And you're good to go on the new adjustable archery bands for our slingbows. Thanks for watching.